They said Austria would be pretty in winter.
And then you have this amazing view in winter.
Getting smaller and smaller and smaller.
Hello everyone, and this time we're going to explore the lakes near Salzburg, Mondsee, St. Wolfgang, the Meer near Hallstatt, and maybe some other places as well. So that's for today, and enjoy this beautiful December rainy weather in Austria.
And let's start this epic journey with a less epic start in Mondsee.
They said Austria would be pretty in winter. Austria would be perfectly fine with snow. Well, this is the view at Mondsee, a very pretty lake. Yeah, I think you need to imagine the view. Yeah, Austria in winter. Perfect.
Yeah, our journey didn't start great in terms of weather, did it? From the Mondsee, we continued our journey to St. Gilgen. Let's see if anything is different here.
From the Mondsee, we drove to St. Gilgen and the Wolfgangsee. And when we were driving around, it slowly moved into a more snowy looking area, which looks very pretty here on the background. It's still wet, it's still raining, but it looks way prettier. And there's a cable car there as well, where we're going later. And if it's too expensive, we're not going up, but we'll see what the price is. And otherwise, we're driving around and enjoying the beauty of the snowy mountains next to the St. Wolfgangsee.
St. Gilgen at least existed already since 1376. However, Austria is Christian and Christmas just passed. This gave some extra challenges.
For the record, it's the 27th of December. Christmas is gone. It's 11:30 at the moment. And this town, like as you can see here, this shop here is closed. There the shops are closed. It's still very empty.
From St. Gilgen, we continued our journey to Bad Iesel, a place where we discovered a wonderful cafe.
After driving a whole day from Salzburg to Mondsee to St. Gilgen, next to the St. Wolfgangsee, we're now in Bad Iesel in Sauner, enjoying some cake, a sandwich, later on a banana milkshake, and the prices are really affordable here as well for such a luxury place, as you can see.
Was the cake itself good as well?
As you might see, my cake is getting smaller and smaller and smaller. That means this is not the first take that we're taking this. That means it tastes still as nice as at my first bite, which is like suikertorte without the apple jam inside, but instead it's chocolate cream inside, and it tastes really nice chocolatey. Still as nice as my first bite.
It was time to take a rest. We drove back to St. Wolfgang to get some sleep and continued the next day, but with a surprise.
And on our 2-day trip, we're staying at St. Wolfgang. And the nice thing is, when you wake up and it's not rainy and wet, the view is just magnificent for today. It's very lovely and peaceful.
This wasn't the only surprise the weather brought us. It was time to drive to Hallstatt and take a cable car up the mountain to something even better.
We're up. We just came out of the shaft of the salt mine. So let's have a look how it was during our tour of the salt mine.
So let me welcome you here in Hallstatt at the oldest salt mine in the world. My name is Lisa.
How do I look like? I'm fashionable.
Now we are all time travelers and we go back in time for 250 million years.
All the minerals get saved at the dry mining, but it's really hard work every day.
If you want to visit the salt mine, these are the prices to take into consideration.
If you want to visit the salt mines in Hallstatt, you can take up a cable car, which will cost you 18 euros or 10 euros if you combine it with your entrance ticket to the salt mine, which is 34 euros in total. And then you have this
amazing view in winter.
Don't leave the place after you have visited the mines. What about visiting Hallstatt itself?
So after the salt mine, you can explore Hallstatt as well next to Hallstatt Sea. But as you can see here, there's loads of tourists, and we're on another spot just on the other side of the town where loads of tourists are taking pictures as well. It's a pretty place, but there are some more villages next to the sea where you have a little bit of more like place for yourself.
Yes, it is busy with tourists. However, this 16th century place prospered due to the salt mining activities, and its place is a perfect combination of lake, old village and mountain. That leaves me with only one last thing to say.
That was a brilliant 2-day road trip to Austria with rain, miserable weather, but we're finishing with this beautiful winter view, what you would expect of Austria during winter. I can highly recommend you to rent a car and explore the villages in between Salzburg and Vienna. And after driving a whole day from, I wanted to say St. Petersburg, but that would be very far.